the following is going to contain massive spoilers for the second dream and the war within quests. If you haven't completed the second dream and wish to remain unspoiled, this is your opportunity to back out now. All good. Awesome. Today, we're talking about operators. At some point a while back, I decided I needed a challenge. Partly as a forced get-good exercise, but also because I thought it would be fun to take a break from relatively standard Warframe gameplay by focusing on the operator aspect of the Warframe universe. Also, in case my mild obsession with Riven mods didn't give it away, I like puzzles and challenges, and finding different ways to approach a problem. While they may not seem as such at first, operators can be extremely useful, from providing helpful buffs to allies to debuffing enemies, and when properly leveled and equipped, can be quite tanky and destructive. And, because I like a challenge, I decided that I would not only attempt to complete every standard boss fight using only my operator from start to finish, but do so, while following a self-made set of rules, just to make it more interesting. Here are the challenge rules. No Warframe usage. The operator must be used for all actions and combat during the mission. Any use of Warframe weapons or abilities automatically results in challenge failure. The use of companions, pets, and/or gear is permitted. No manual Warframe movement. Relocating the Warframe to a better storage location, or to checkpoint map progress, is permitted, but only via transference. A 5-step grace rule is permitted for accidental Warframe movement. Knockouts count as death. Losing all health and getting snapped back into the Warframe counts as a death. 5 deaths are permitted, the 6th will result in challenge failure. Additionally, it's my intention that this challenge will only involve standard bosses. Field bosses, such as random ambulance appearances outside of its assassination mission, and grand bosses, such as the orbs and the Eidolons, aren't counted here. I haven't made up my mind yet on whether I'm going to attempt the Roper low list, as that boss fight is quite literally designed to limit the use and abilities of the operator as much as possible. Well, now that the challenge is explained and the rules are set, I think it's time to pay a visit to Captain Vore.